Education is non-refundable. Milkshakes are not an appropriate breakfast.
It seems that Agatha Sphere and the Orb Foundation are targeting the county's colleges in an attempt to appeal to a younger demographic. Those orb-happy loons must be subdued at all cost. But wasting their time trying to brainwash our brainless students seems like a terrific diversion. I'm so glad we found a use for our horde of unwashed undergraduates.
Talking on campus. Thank you. Stupid questions will make you look stupid. Thank you.
And now for the segment we call Agony Answers. You provide the agony and I'll provide the answers. This week's problem is from Helpless in Hogsport. I'm stuck in my bathroom. I think the doorknob fell off. What should I do? Well, I start by contacting someone under less anonymous circumstances. Perhaps a friend or the local authorities. Best of luck and so on.
To whom it may concern, I'm so disappointed in you. Thank you. Staff are reminded to be inspirational. Questions. No, I wasn't listening. Where your class is it really worth going?
Thank you.
case you hadn't noticed.
Harrison Wolf on 2-Point Radio. Welcome to 2-Point Radio. This is Harrison Wolf, and I will be your host at this little sonic get-together. This is the party within the party. The sandwich and the lunchbox. The thing in the thing. I'll think of some words, and we'll be right back.
We're sorry for the litter that you... Oh, sorry, that's mine. Has opened a new building. Good for us. Stupid questions will make you look stupid.
the news today, local film star Roderick Cushion is in a spot of bother after he was photographed throwing a bagel at some photographers. It's pretty bad luck that those freelance photographers were in his bathroom at the exact moment he decided to start flinging bagels. I mean, what are the chances?
Students are asked not to ask questions.
I've lived in Two Point County for more years than I can remember, but every now and then I still hear an expression for the first time. This morning, I bumped into Ricky Hawthorne, and after a nice chat, he says, "Time to see a man about a dolphin." I have no idea what it could mean. Don't tell me though, that man's an enigma, and I choose to keep him that way.
Are reminded to bounce back from heart-wrenching disappointment. Sorry.
we all like a milkshake? But drinking too much milk can and will make you uncontrollably ill. Be safe and try to have very slightly less than that. This message is brought to you by the Milkmaid Corporation.
Janitor needed to unblock toilets. Lovely. Are reminded to fork it over. Shouldn't you be working?
And Wolf, talking the days away on 2 Point Radio. We got a lot more radical radio for you today. There will be music, there will be speaking, and if we're lucky, we'll have some county-shaking news that'll make us see life differently. Forever. But first, I gotta find my pencil. Wish me luck.
Students are reminded to set reminders.
Thank you.
I had a pretty sweet segment lined up for you, but my producer is waving his arms at me through the glass. Yep, waving back hasn't seemed to help much. I'll see what he has to say while you listen to my new favorite song.
There's a fly in here. If it's not on your CV, it didn't happen. Not to me. In your hands, partly.
Sorry about that confusion. It was nothing serious. My producer just had certain opinions about the content I had planned. I like being censored as much as the next guy, but little did they know, they can't stop me thinking about it. The brain is the last refuge of the so-called undesirable thought. It's a party up there, and boy, is it a fun one.
Pay off. students are reminded to have the time of their lives. Students are reminded that you're letting everyone down. Staff are reminded to be inspirational.
That's it for today's show. I don't know if it's been a classic, but who am I to say? These things need to marinate in the passing of time. Only then will we know if today was a classic day. Who knows? Maybe what I'm saying right now is making or breaking the show. Have I just ruined it? What about now? Trippy. I'll be back for more radio in the future.
Asked questions. Yes, we are testing you. This is a test announcement, not a real announcement. Thank you. Tuition fees may be spent on administrative bonuses. Should be placed in bins. Is that too complicated for you? To apologize to the janitorial staff. I'm sure you've done something. Are reminded that school spirit is infectious. Go us!
Hi, I'm Felicity Bellbottoms, and you may be listening to Campus Radio. Unfortunately, our broadcasting signal has taken a hit due to some of our equipment being prematurely recycled. One of our reporters is in a skip, looking for the parts as we speak. So, consider that colourful visual, and we'll be right back.
Maintenance announcement. Plants need water, remember?
And so is our broadcasting signal, thanks to Hugh for getting in the skip. By his own account, he was happy to do it, adding that the view from inside the skip offered him an entirely new perspective on campus. Now, if that's not an idea for a segment, I don't know what is.
Frequently asked questions. No, your chicken should not be pink.
Hugh, who's fresh out the skip with a story about an unusually cloudy weekend for one of the county's hottest locations.
Breaking Point campus, we're expecting a weekend full of sun, laughter, and knockabout fun. But a dark cloud has washed away their optimism, leaving them with sadness and no real use for all that sun cream. They were forecast a weekend of sun and balmy temperatures, but what they got was a drizzly and altogether grey affair. Spare a thought for them, sitting inside. Their sandals, sandless. Their skin, cool and unburnt. Fliss, back to you.
Students with medical issues should go to the health clinic. The academic year is starting soon. Was there anything we wanted to do? Enjoy your summer. I know I will. The end of year results have been released. Luck won't help you now. Reminded that dogs don't eat homework. Students should check in before trying to learn. It's not your year, it's just another year.
How do you follow up the best-selling album in Two Point County history with even more music?
Even more.
Jasmine Odyssey presents Even More.
Hitting the books doesn't mean what you think it means. We'll be right back. students are reminded to find themselves.
Hearing that the board students in Breaking Point have been seen riding around campus in maintenance carts used by janitorial staff and the local Coast Guard. It's a sobering reminder to all of us that you can't take a golf cart without asking just because it's a bit cloudy.
Students are reminded that this is the fun part. Talking on campus. Thank you. Students should report all issues to someone that cares. Plagiarism is not a belief system. guests are reminded that you came here on purpose.
Sir Nigel Bickleworth on 2 Point Radio. Hello, hello. Today we're discussing, for the very first time, ironically, sequels. Yes, that's right. When the wicked and wretched behind something decide that it's a good idea to bless us all once again with the second pressing of their already tenuous idea.
Students are reminded to be constantly upbeat. Needed to unlock toilets. Lovely.
Sequelization, or the art of doing something again, is derived from the Greek word sequalid, meaning lazy, repetitive, or in some way redundant. It would seem that the ancients are trying to tell you something. Ambitionless auteurs of our times. Thank you.
Distracted students should pretend that they're listening. Questions. No, I wasn't listening. Education is non-refundable.
Sequelization, or the art of doing something again. Wait, no, we've covered that already. See what I did there? I almost repeated myself and then decided not to. It is possible. Up next, something fresh.
Thank you. asked questions. No, you can't have an extension.
At Jumbo, we know it's our employees that are the big deal. That's why they get the Jumbo treatment. Mobile stationery, toilet substitute, sip of milk, leg rooms, dental surgeries, additional headrest, and our famous data system analysis training program system, or FNAPSTAPS. I'm Jumbo McNally, and I wish I worked here.
Visitors should be checked in and then removed immediately. Reminded to try and keep up. That some of you are doing better than others.
Repetition seems to me to be at the heart of all of our cultural and social failings. Oh, what comfort you all seem to take in your cookie-cutter days. Another weekend, another roach burger, another glorified re-release at the picture theater. Come on, people, come out there and live! Join me tomorrow on 2 Point Radio, where I'll be talking about my collection of ceramic voles.
Announcement. Milkshakes are not enough.
You are getting in touch about one particular sequel. Yes, the follow-up to Mr. Cushion's positively poisonous production, Perilous Spandex. The only thing hazardous about that particular picture is watching it. The sequel, entitled Perilous Spandex 2, The Handles of Love, received the coveted Piece of Garbage Award. A little award that I bestow to highlight, as a public service announcement really, those films most bereft of value in our county's rich tradition of abominable filmmaking.
Despite the rumours, the campus grounds are not a toilet. Are responsible for, well, for a lot actually.
This has been exhausting. We shan't be doing it again, because unlike all you reproduction-peddling, washed-up rehash monkeys, we, at 2 Point Radio, know when to stop.
Doctor, return to the hospital. Thank you. end of year is approaching. It's too late to start trying. Students are reminded to be in two places at once. Summer break would be a convenient time for construction. Results have been released. Luck won't help you now.
And that's the show. Of course, this has all been delivered to you with one rather heavy caveat. If I were ever to be involved in a second rendition of anything, I can be certain in telling you that it would be for good reason. And, if anything, would surely be a bigger, better, pickle-worthier version of what had come before it.
How was that? Little Ryan?
If it's not on your CV, it didn't happen. Not to me. In your hands, partly. students are reminded to figure it out themselves. Should be placed in bins. Is that too complicated for you?
It's the Harrison Wolf Show, baby. All right. This is Harrison Wolf bringing you the Harrison Wolf Power Hour. I've been seeing a lot of stuff about colleges lately. Lots of study here, learn so-and-so, qualification this and qualification that. But let me tell you something they don't want you to know. It's a scam. All of it.
Doctor, return to the hospital. Thank you.
We've all been quizzed at school, but what really happens during a test? You get a question, you write down your answer, And then some bozo tells you that you're wrong. But who's to say they're right? What's so great about their answers? If we've all got the same answers, then what's the point of there being so many of us, huh? I tell you, it's a crime that they make kids take their tests. Not a real criminal kind of crime, of course, but it's majorly uncool. And that's the kind of crime.
Frequently asked questions. No, you can't have an extension. Questions. No, I will not be your friend. Don't eat home. Students are reminded to find themselves.
I shouldn't have to tell you, but if Jumbo McNally's getting involved in something, you know it's bad. Jumbo University? Huh, what a racket. You can teach Mr. McNally a lesson by signing my petition to have him fired into space.
That you... Oh, sorry, that's mine. report. Yep. Seems fine. Visitors should be checked in and then removed immediately.
At Bungle, we know what young people want in a motor vehicle. Independence. Fun.
Woohoo!
Wheels. Beaver from Bungle. The car that puts the E in freedom.
I'm so disappointed in you. Thank you. Gives you a bright future and clouds it with debt. To try and keep up.
ever thought about why they're so keen to teach us to read? Think about it. So we can read what they write. Well, it makes so much sense when you think about it. It's just another way for them to control us. That's why I only trust the Daily Disorder for my news. They take the regular news and turn every word into an anagram, breaking down the code. You can't understand a thing. It's perfect.
Announcement. Shouldn't you be working? Students are reminded to fork it over. Stupid questions will make you look stupid.
You think I got into radio because of some fancy piece of paper? No, sir. Radio is pure jazz, man. It's alive and unpredictable. You can't just learn it. Sure, you could pay some big shot to tell you which buttons to press and when, and that's fine. But that's not radio. Not really. Here's another previously scheduled song that I didn't choose.
Are reminded that some of you are doing better than others.
Thank you.
talking on campus. Thank you.
Here's a question from Kevin in Flotterang. Hey Harrison, what was your favorite project in school? Well, it's a good question, and you gotta remember, just because education is a scam doesn't mean all those teachers are bad people. So, to answer your question, I used to like making the little volcano. It's pretty trippy to learn that volcanoes are full of vinegar, right? But how do we collect it safely? I don't know. But that's what they ought to be teaching us, man.
Take time on your assignments, if you think you have time. Milkshakes are not an appropriate breakfast. Students are reminded that I'm not your mum.
I never went to college. At least, I don't remember going to college. Anyway, I turned out just fine. Join me at the same time tomorrow, when the day sun goes bye-bye and the spooky white beach ball casts down its dark favor on us all. Good night.
Education is non-refundable. end of year is approaching. It's too late to start trying. Listening, you were asleep. I saw you. The academic year is starting soon. Was there anything you wanted to do? Your results are now available. No unauthorized panicking. Students are reminded to be in two places at once.
you're listening to Campus Radio. I'm DJ Shorts, bringing you small batch homegrown radio with the pulp left in. Here's a musical palate cleanser that's sure to wash that pre-digested rubbish out of your ears. See if you can taste the difference.
Students are reminded to be nice to each other. If you aren't, who else will? That they're easily replaceable.
Talk about an actor by the name of Roderick Cushion. Now, if you listen to popular thinking, you'd think, now there's a guy who's given up on his craft. There's an actor that would literally do anything for the next paycheck. And sure, I can see how you could think that. But you'd be completely missing the point. When Roderick Cushion decides to do yet another truly terrible film, he's making a statement about the nature of commercial cinema. Thank you, Mr. Cushion, for fighting the good fight.
Announcement. Hitting the box doesn't mean what you think it means. Letting everyone down. pencils down. Only kidding.
We've got a music review for you now. Over to Maggie, who's been to see the Boogie Nights.
That's right. I went to the Boogie Nights concert, and it was great. The lights, the dancing, and so on. If you like music, this really was music. I think the campus could do with some better signage, though. I mean, I almost missed the concert, and this segment could have been a real train wreck if that had happened.
Janitor to repair machinery. Cheating is the wrong kind of clever. Should report all issues to someone that cares. Announcements are closer than they appear. Thank you. Mm-hmm.
New to the Crummy student range. Fish in a box. We at Crumley have been serving fish to Two Point County for over 10 years. It's a proud tradition, and now it's a tradition in a box. Easy to cook. Wow. Tasty to eat. Wow. You're not sure what it is, but it's definitely in a box. Mmm, just like Mama used to make.
Students are reminded to make us proud. Or else. Your food is cold because the oven wasn't on. Are reminded that there's no such thing as free time.
Nah, I think the Orb Foundation gets far too much criticism. Sure, there's some dodgy information about how they're funded, and they do talk a lot about the Orb being the perfect shape. I can't be the only one sick of those adverts. But really, what are they, if not a group of people coming together to appreciate some beauty in this world? Personally, I think we could all learn a little something from them.
Tuition fees may be spent on administrative bonuses. Please drink some water. Thank you. futurism is not a belief system. Administrator is reminded to stay hydrated. Frequently asked questions. No, I've not seen your frog. End of year is approaching. It's too late to start trying. Is starting soon. Was there anything we wanted to do? Results have been released. Luck won't help you now.
Sir Nigel Bickleworth on 2 Point Radio. It's me, Sir Nigel Bickleworth, the voice coming out of your radio here on 2 Point Radio. Isn't it a beautiful day in this little county of ours? Not that I'd know, of course. No windows in the old recording booth. And while I have made several written requests to our management, This is actually just the way I like it.
Frequently asked questions. No, I wasn't listening. The campus has opened a new building. Good for us.
If it's quite all right with you, I'd like to discuss crockery. Any objections?
No?
Delightful. Yes, I don't know who needs to hear this. I'd imagine it's most of you, but plating is not optional. When you slop food onto a tray, you turn your food into slop. Remember, we eat with our eyes. Though I'm sure some of you will take that as an instruction to start shoveling chowder into your sockets.
Maintenance announcement. Plants need water, remember? Are reminded that this is the fun part.
It's time for Agony Answers, where I solve one of your tiny little problems with minimal effort. The following is from Forlorn in Freshly. Nigel, the other day, I accidentally left my dissertation on the bus. Could you please spread the word and see if I can get it back? Thanks in advance. Well, well, this is what you get for riding the bus. As for your request, I'd love to help you. I really would. But if I did, how would you learn? You see my dilemma?
Students are reminded to set reminders. To apologize to the janitorial staff. I'm sure you've done something.
Beaver from Bungle. The small car that makes the little things feel bigger than they are. It's a perspective thing.
Distracted students should pretend that they're listening. Students are reminded that some grades are personal. needed to bounce back from heart-wrenching disappointment.
Sir Nigel Bickleworth, laughing at you, not with you, on 2 Point Radio. We can all do with an occasional chuckle. It keeps the blood fizzy and the vitals convivial. So I present to you this next piece of music that is sure to give us all a good, long laugh.
Showering is technically, but not socially, optional. Staff are reminded to be inspirational.
Oh, sorry. Wasn't that terrible? Ah, I needed that. On the subject of laughing, and indeed needing, I see that many of our county's students are petitioning for additional reading materials. Frankly, I find it very funny. If you didn't already possess all of the course materials, why would you start the course? How bizarre.
Unattended sandwiches will be eaten by me. Questions. You can find the bathroom yourself. I believe in you.